everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to use the limit comparison test to determine whether or not a series converges or diverges. And in this particular case, we've been asked to find the sum of the series from 2 to infinity of 10n squared divided by the quantity n cubed minus 1. So with the limit comparison test, and I've taken a screenshot here of the rules that you're going to use for the limit comparison test. This is from the table of convergence tests that I have on my website. But what we need is two series. One is our original series, a sub n, and we've already got that here. We'll call this a sub n. But we need a second series called b sub n that we'll take from pieces of a sub n. And we need to know that both of those series are greater than zero for all values of n, and that the limit as n approaches infinity of our original series, a sub n, divided by the modified series, b sub n, is going to be greater than zero. If those things are true, then we can conclude that no matter what, that whatever happens to b sub n also happens to a sub n. So if all of those things are true and b sub n converges, then a sub n also converges. And similarly, if all those things are true and b sub n diverges, then a sub n is also going to diverge. So the first thing we need to do is figure out what b sub n is going to be. What we want to do is we want to take the terms of a sub n that are going to have the greatest effect on the magnitude of the function here. In other words, the terms that are, you know, most meaningful. For example, if we plugged in the number 10,000 for n to our original series a sub n, right? If we plug in 10,000 for n, then you can see here that 10n squared is going to have a big effect. N cubed is going to have a big effect. But you'll have these two huge numbers, and then one here, negative one, is going to be a tiny, tiny, tiny insignificant piece of this fraction compared to the other two terms. So that means that 10n squared and n cubed are going to have the largest effect on the magnitude. We don't have to consider the coefficient here, 10. We just want the variables. So we're going to say that b sub n is going to be equal to n squared divided by n cubed, which we can simplify to be 1 over n. And that is actually the harmonic series, which we know diverges. So we'll call this the harmonic series. And remember, we already know that the harmonic series diverges. That's just something that is a given that we remember from sequences and series. So we've got the harmonic series. That'll be b sub n. So now we need to make sure that for all n, a sub n and b sub n are always going to be greater than 0. Well, we know that n begins at 2, right? So we're interested in all numbers 2 and greater. You can imagine here for a sub n, if we plug in the number 2, right, we'll get a sub n of 2, let's call it, right? We'll get 10 times 2 squared, which is going to give us 40 in the numerator. And then in the denominator, we'll get 2 cubed, which is 8 minus 1 is 7. We get 40 over 7. You can imagine that if we continue plugging in 3, 4, 5, 6 positive numbers, the numerator is always going to be positive, and the denominator is always going to be positive. So a sub n is always going to be greater than 0. Similarly, for b sub n, if we start at n equals 2, right, we'll get 1 half. And then if we plug in 3, we'll get 1 third. Plug in 4, we'll get 1 fourth, etc., right? That's always going to be a positive number. Nothing we could plug in that's greater than 2 is going to make this a negative value. So we also know that b sub n is going to be greater than 0. So we can see that both of those things are true. So we can check off this, that a sub n is greater than 0 and b sub n is greater than 0. Now we need to know, well, we need to find L, right? We need to do this part here. We're going to take the limit as n approaches infinity of our original series a sub n divided by our modified series b sub n, and whatever we get as our result is going to be L. We're going to call it L. So we're going to take the limit as n approaches infinity. Right now that we've shown that both a sub n and b sub n are greater than 0, we're going to proceed with the calculation. So the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n, which is our original series. So we've got 10n squared divided by n cubed minus 1. And we're going to divide that whole thing by b sub n, which we know to be 1 over n. So now we want to just go ahead and simplify this before we try plugging in infinity. So instead of dividing by this fraction here, we can multiply by its inverse. Hopefully you'll remember that from algebra. When you divide by a fraction, you can instead multiply by the inverse. So instead of dividing by 1 over n, we'll multiply by n over 1. So when I combine those two fractions, I'll get 10n cubed over n cubed minus 1. So now from this point, I can go ahead and divide through the entire fraction by n cubed. Remember that this is a useful tool when you're trying to evaluate an infinity, when you have a limit as n approaches infinity or whatever your variable is approaches infinity. You can divide through the entire fraction by the variable with the largest degree. So n cubed is the highest degree variable here in our fraction. If we had an n to the fourth, we would divide through by n to the fourth. But if we divide through by n cubed, what we'll get is just 10 in the numerator, because 10n cubed divided by n cubed is just 10. The n cubed cancels. And then when we divide through the denominator here, n cubed divided by n cubed will give us 1, and then 1 divided by n cubed will stay right here. So we divided each term in our fraction in both the numerator and denominator by n cubed. Now, the reason we do this is because now when we evaluate at infinity, we know that when the denominator of a fraction, and we're talking this particular fraction right here, when the denominator of this fraction becomes very, very, very large, as it will when we start plugging in very large numbers, when the denominator gets very large, infinitely large, this whole fraction here is going to become zero. No matter what's in the numerator, unless it's also infinity, the denominator will be infinitely large and that fraction will become zero, which means that what we're left with here, as n approaches infinity, is just 10 over 1, which of course is just 10. So 10 is going to be equal to L. Remember here from our theorem, we were looking for L. And L needed to be greater than 0, right? We needed to make sure that L was greater than 0, and in this case, it is. 10 is obviously greater than 0. We have therefore met all conditions that we need to in order to be able to use the limit comparison test. So now that we know for a fact we can use the limit comparison test, we need to compare B sub n and A sub n, right? So B sub n, if it converges or diverges, then A sub n is going to do the same thing. So we know that B sub n is the harmonic series which we know diverges, which means that A sub n must also diverge. So we can say A sub n diverges by limit comparison test. And that's it. Comparison test. All right, so that's it. That's our final answer. I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.